Welcome back, people. Jason134 here, back with another episode of Alaskan Road Truckers. Alright, so we got ourselves our next job. It was just up the road from where we delivered our last one. I did customize my truck while there, repaired it, and got it, I still gotta buy fuel, but I'll buy fuel along the way if I can. I don't know if there actually is a gas station anywhere up here. There's a gas station all the way down in Coldfoot.
Yeah, I'm gonna head out.
All right.
Yeah.
Plug that little baby in there. Plug that in here. Alright, let's get on the road. Get on the road. We got a long ways to go in order to get to Coldfoot so we can get some fuel, and we'll sleep down there once we get there. Got a long ways to go and a short time to get there. Da 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 da
Can't even really hear the radio there. At least I can't. I know I got 100 miles, just over 100 miles to Coldfoot and that gas station that I need to get to. I guess I really don't need to get there, but that's where I'm gonna rest. Somewhere around that area. I put better tires on my truck. I got a brand new paint job. I put a bumper on my truck, a good looking one, and I fixed my truck up completely at the workshop. It was expensive, yes, but it was worth it because now I won't have nearly as much trouble with the grip. I won't slide around as much, hopefully. gotta get down there. Gotta drive, drive, drive. We gotta go, 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 and drive some more. I know my GPS ain't working, nor is my main map. Both my map and GPS aren't working. Well, the one that's supposed to be in the left-hand corner of the screen, that one's not working. Then my GPS is being all glitchy and whatever, so I can't really see the map. So I'm just gonna have to follow the directions given. See, I would have slid on that turn right there with my standard basic tires. But now I'm actually able to make sharp turns pretty easily. I have no idea what the flying fuck I just hit, but it literally pitched my truck way up in the air. And yeah, no, that right there is braking immersion. It should be fixed. There is nothing in the game that literally should throw your truck up in the air like that. Doesn't matter what it is. There's nothing that can literally throw a truck like this heavy that high up in the air. Not usually. I might have hit a cone possibly, but I don't think I hit anything. I think I was just having a wrestling match with the clutch there for a second. Fog is thick. It really is. Is it always like this up here? I've maxed out my speedometer at 56 miles an hour. I'm doing this even faster than I was coming up here. See how long he just kept his eyes closed for right there? That's two or three seconds. That's enough time for you to have an accident right there. So I need to find myself a spot to stop so I can get some sleep, hopefully. Maybe there'll be a parking space somewhere up ahead. I'm on the watch for a parking area so I can stop and get some rest, but I've not seen anything in the last minute or so. down there for a second. Dear God. Friggin' burn! They're like an off-road turbo truck now. Hell, I didn't even put any of the engine components in it, but damn. These tires are freaking very high powered. I didn't do it. Okay then. Well, I'm not gonna make shit on this job. I didn't think there'd be a fence there. I mean, I assumed there'd be a fence, but I'm getting kind of desperate for a stop point because, I mean, seriously, I'm not going to end up passing out on the road, and I really don't want to fucking... I don't think I can just stop in the middle of the freaking road and pass out. No, I can't. That's theoretically is illegal on a multitude of levels. I have to deliver it if I don't want to get a penalty. I have a feeling the penalty will be really freaking nasty. There's my first major accident right there. Yeah, I know. I'm not a professional truck driver. If anything, I'm way less than even a rookie. Now, in American Truck Simulator, I'm actually pretty decent because, I mean, there's no Alaska, so the map's not nearly as bad. And most of the main truck routes are usually highways, so... 9 times out of 10, it's a highway you're going to be traveling on.
Warning, obstacle on the road. This ain't how you're supposed to park, but dude, like, sheesh, man. I had to get some sleep. At least I know there's a few parking spots way out here in the middle of nowhere. I thought maybe I could find a spot to stop my truck and get some sleep, but no. The moment the game actually loads in where I stop, there's actually a fence, pipes, and a bunch of other random stuff just sitting there. So it didn't even load all the props in time for me to avoid that massive accident I had, because I came into town a little too fast, so the game didn't have time to fully render everything. Hopefully won't be making any nasty trips all the way up there anymore. At least not for a while. I'll keep them short runs. Hopefully in the future they'll have like live feed type stuff, where as the game progresses you'll get constant updates and changes to the road conditions. Because I'm pretty sure that's how they do it in real life. You can call the dispatch for road conditions or something, and like they'll give you reports of the area. I think that's how it works. I'm not really sure if it's. I think they'll give you at least what they have available road conditions, because I don't really know exactly how it works. coming in fast and hot. Fast and hot. We're coming in fast and hot. Fast and hot. We're coming in so fast the game's actually lagging just a little bit, like stuttering just even just the smallest amount because I'm going so fast. Rocket fast driving, rocket fast, it's a blast. Any deliveries have been made. Get it lined up almost just right. Thank you. Most likely not gonna make shit from this job because I had that accident. It deteriorated the job. Well, I got $600. I mean, hell, that's enough to buy some fuel. Let's see where we're going next. Obviously, I want to work my way back over to my work, my house, but I want to be able to take something over there with me. At least try. Alright, so, we're gonna go and take our truck back and head down to the, HQ, and we're gonna, yeah. Back to the other side of the map, back to the HQ, because there's only one HQ here, clearly.
followed up in a moment.
Just passed by that too. Still, they do look nice. Ish. Gotta select the month. I'm out. Thank you. gonna do is hit R space or space R, depending on it. If you're about to start going, if you just got in your truck, hit space R space. If you're getting out of your truck, then hit space R. It's quick. It's the quick action for starting and stopping. To get in, your truck will get out of your truck. I'm guessing Pudho Bay is where you would cross using the ice roads, probably. Most likely. Got Circle, Tuglin, Vendale, Fairbanks, Yano. But Pudho is probably where the ice road is going to start coming in, because it's the closest town to the actual ocean area. Sea area, probably. Maybe. Now let's see what I got back here. I wonder if I can actually remove this. I know there are people that actually do this. Like, if you live in an area where there's a lot of trees that fall on a regular basis or a severe blockage hazard, like rocks or trees or whatever, there's usually people that will do that on a regular basis. They'll go out and clear trees or stuff from roadways. Hello. I must have chainsaw to do this. Really? Where's a nearby shop at? Auto parts? There's several different types of shops, apparently. I need to go to the auto parts store anyway, so I can buy a bulk amount of oil, like big cans of oil or whatever. If it's only small things of oil, then I need to get whatever I can, get like three or four of each one of oil and coolant, as well as maybe like two fuses, so I can actually get some XP in this department here, I guess. Allows to make basic repairs. I'm not exactly sure what that would do, aside from maybe allow you to possibly take off a tire or something, or do some of the most basic maintenance to your truck, oil, coolant, and a few other things. Anyways, I think that'll do it for this episode of Alaskan Road Truckers. If you liked it, please like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you again in the next one. We'll find a new job in the next one as well. Peace!